Good evening, everyone. It is such a pleasure to be here. I am from India, and I have to say, whenever I travel abroad, I will always have one very well-meaning person, even before I get off the flight, who'll be like, oh my God, Aditi, you're from India, but your English is really good. When did you learn? So now I could be like, well, the British came over 200 years ago and inserted English into the private education system, and about 130 million Indians can speak English today. But I'm like, you know what? On the way here. I came by boat, so I was able to brush up on grammar and conversation as well. It's really nice to be in Australia because I am referred to here as a comedian. In India, I am referred to as a female comedian. And one of the top stereotypes associated with a female comedian, of course, is that they talk about sex too much. Too much sex. I'll constantly get people on the internet being like, excuse me, you're talking too much about Bob's and Vagine. Bob's and Vagine is Indian internet for boobs and vagina, because why should you be able to spell it if you haven't seen it? And here's the thing, whenever someone offers me that as a criticism, I'm like, I think actually you're just jealous I get paid to talk about Bob's and Vagine. Second, let's not act like everybody doesn't love Bob's and Vagine. We sell everything from our potato chips to our sports cars on the basis of Bob's and Vagine. The world runs on a fuel that is generated by Bob's and Vagine. But I've realized people love Bob's and Vagine, but they don't like Bob's and Vagine when it has a human body attached to it. And when that body has a mouth, and when words are coming out of that mouth. Just don't know what to do. And that's the thing. The expectation from someone as a possessor of said Bob's and Vagine is always that you have to act like you don't know the power of the Bob's and Vagine. That you're not even acknowledging the existence of the Bob's and Vagine. So every time a guy touches my boob for the first time, I'm normally like, oh my God, this wasn't here before you touched it. Do you want to do the other side? I don't want it to be lopsided. It'll be stressful while buying a bra. The other thing, of course, that I've lived a stereotype about being a female comedian, which is that nobody wants to have sex with a female comedian. Now, this could just be me, but that is another different set of jokes altogether. The thing is, just imagine the ugliest male comedian you've met. Okay, the ugliest one, and I kind of know who everyone's imagining. He will have a coterie of young women, just cleavages and marker pens aloft, being like, can you sign this? Wow, he is so humble. He's so self-aware. He's so right. Men and women are really different, you know. But nobody wants to fuck a female comedian. And I guess men don't want to fuck a female comedian because they think if you fuck a female comedian, she'll look at your dick and make a joke. Let me clarify for all the men out there, she doesn't need to be a female comedian to look at your dick and make a joke. It's less a function of the job, more a function of the fact that dicks look hilarious. Have you seen a dick? I don't believe dudes just don't crack up every time they go to pee. Like, in fact, let me tell you my first dick story. Nostalgia. I was 10 years old, right? I was walking towards the bus stop, number 33. And behind number 33 bus stop was a gentleman with his trousers open, changing the gear on his manual transmission. Now, I was 10 years old, so I wasn't a pervert then. But if there is rhythmic motion in the vicinity, your eyes tend to get attracted, right? You're like, whoa. And I was just looking at this. I was like, oh my God, did his large intestine just fall out? This is insane. But then even as a 10-year-old, I knew, Aditi, this is not good. You should not be looking at this. So I tried to tear my eyes away. The problem was they went straight to his face. And I saw that he was making direct eye contact with me. Just tsukka, 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 tsukka. Sorry, Indian guy. So tsukka, tsukka, tsukka. You are like, oh my God, is this the story of loss of innocence? I say it's the story of the gain of wisdom. Because that was the day I decided I wanted to be a man. Not because of anything, but because I wanted the confidence to be able to walk out on the streets with my trousers open, thinking surely kids on their way to school want to see this. And that's the thing. You know, we've been talking about gender equality, you know, between the sexes. Everyone's very much into this conversation. But I believe we have a very long way to go. I believe we will achieve true gender equality on the day that you find me behind number 33 bus stop, my hand deep inside my pants. Sukka, 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 sukka. Bye, children. And that's the visual I want to leave you with. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.